10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to the Dota 2 Champions League. I'm Lysander, going to be joined here by Kips, and we are in the final game between Severus as well as Panther Sports. Both team one point each, and Monkey King finally getting the banned stick.
Yeah, that was kind of necessary, but instead, Penta get themselves the Earth Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
And that is a specialist kind of hero, so I'm really looking forward to what their specialist is going to be able to do with that. Also, taking out are the TA and TSF. So TA 2000 is not going to be playing that TA this time around. And the Sand King also taken off the board by Cerberus, and they once again trust in the Weaver and Ogre Magi. So a couple of the same elements here.
Yeah, similar elements. Yes. Disruptor, very strong against Weaver though. Pulling back into the Static Storm, you have Earth Spirit that has a lot of control as well. I like this Silencer pick. You mentioned Silencer for game one, and now it's back for game number three instead.
Yeah, they actually managed to pick it up. I'd say that you want to run this as a core silencer mid, and you do the same thing as before. You run the Ogre Magi there to try and secure the lane. This time against an Earth Spirit instead of against a Monkey King, which is a hero with a little bit less mobility. So perhaps this time they won't get caught off guard by the Monkey King rotating so fast. And Penta go ahead and dig right back into the Nyx Assassin.
Yeah. Nyx Assassin didn't do too well against the Weaver the last time as well, though.
I presume it's mostly to deal with the Silencer to harass him as much as possible. That mana burn is really gonna hurt against that big int pool. So Cerberus are still looking at probably a support, and then finally there could be an offlaner.
Yeah. Could be a mid silencer as well.
Offlane.
Or is that not done anymore?
Yeah. Mid silencer?
Yeah.
No, that's exactly what I expect them to be doing.
Okay. I see a lot of 2-1-2 silencers though. A lot of 2-1-2 silencers so that they offset their XP experience sharing. They have Ogre roaming, so it's just Silencer and Weaver in a lane together. I know some teams run mid-Silencer, but the hero is susceptible to a lot of disruption, like a Spirit.
He is. But he is also a lane dominator. There's not a lot of heroes that do well in lane against a Silencer. So it's a higher risk, higher reward kind of hero. And the Magnus in this game does not have a lot of synergy through the Empower, but he is definitely going to be a threat in the team fights combined with his Silencer.
I mean, Jug is still open.
Yes, Jug is open.
Yeah, Jug is still open for them.
For a change.
Jug Magnus is a very popular combo.
You're right. I would say that Penta have to watch out for that one. And then it would put the Silencer on support. Or the Weaver support. I haven't been seeing that much lately. But I think it's still totally viable. So Cerberus have some options. And Penta expect to see a mid-Silencer here, actually. So the Sniper is going to be able to stay out of range of those glaives.
I think now they have themselves an issue with this Sniper pick. They need a proper initiator.
Ban.
Yeah, the Juggernaut ban.
A very nice call from you.
Slark ban as well, I think, yeah. Because I've been seeing a lot, you know, I like to claim credit for it, but ultimately I think a lot of the... Oh, wait. Anti-Mage? Probably? I don't know. They need someone that can blink.
Anti-Mage.
Or jump. Void, Anti-Mage... Do look like possible.
They could go LC.
Yeah, Legion could work. I actually quite like Legion as well. The sniper forces them to actually pick an initiator. Magnus will do sometimes, but you still want to have a hero that can jump right on top of him. But welcome is That's not what I had in mind.
Not what I had in mind either, but we are going for some power farming. And he is... He could have some time depending on how long this Abaddon takes to ramp up. Because this seems to be a safe lane Abaddon.
Mm-hmm.
So...
Slash's way. Let's go.
Yeah, it's gonna be... Radiance? Blade Mail? Blink?
I think it's Vlad's Blink first.
Ah, he builds it like that. That's interesting. I'm a support Abaddon player myself. So... I'm always curious to see how these scaries make sure that they do enough damage to not be ignored. Because that's the risk you run. Here. If you don't do enough damage, people can just sorta pretend you're not there and go after your teammates first.
Yeah, well. We'll see what happens in this game. Let's hop into it. It's the last one for tonight. And yeah, it's going to be Pentasport versus... What's his name? Cerberus. We have them on the Radiant once again. So Mikey playing Nyx Assassin. We have DNZ finally playing Earthsprint instead of Monkey King. We got Sniper played by Blazemon. Got the Carry Abaddon, Skitter. And Disruptor played by Jabs, who has gone really deep into Plant and Observer Ward.
Yeah, and actually the Ogre Magi, once again played by Felt, this guy is just permanent Ogre Magi here. It's almost like Mushy is making me play Battle Cup with him.
Oh, he at least he plays Battle Cup with you. I'm still waiting for someone to carry me on Battle Cup.
I'm not sure if you want to be Ogre Magi for like 6 games in a row. Anyway, TA 2000 gonna be taking up the Alchemist, so he is back to the mid lane. And also here on bot is Juchi on the Magnus. Then towards top, there's the dual lane with Haze on the Weaver and Arrow on that support silencer. So I'll expect Arrow to pick up a Hand of Midas if he gets the time and try and scale as fast as possible. And the Ogre Magi will probably be level 4 at 11 minutes again or something like that. He seems to accept his fate when it comes to that. So,
Mikey, we'll see how well he does in this lane. There is a silencer, and silencer is very notorious for being able to do a lot of damage to an offlaner alone without having much help. So, we'll see how this one turns out.
Yeah, especially on the early levels, if you get a lot of right clicks in, if you get your spells off on them, they are not going to be happy.
Oh, they're starting it for roll, but here comes the ogre as well. So, trade for trades.
Once again, a dual mid lane, and I think kills are going to be happening here. There's no doubt about it.
Oh, silencer blocking off the Nyx Assassin, tried to go for trading here, but Mikey will instead turn it around on him and fight him one-on-one. Oh, Panther getting the kill. How does that even happen?
I'm...
What?
Yeah.
This is curse level 1 with Thunderstrike. How does that even happen?
Apparently they just ran him down. And the Magnus hasn't leveled anything yet. So perhaps he thought he was going to get out. But no such luck.
Okay, you see, these things are... Oh, wow! Weaver dying to the Nyx's Adsin. And these are things that make casters look bad, you know? Kills that shouldn't happen. And make us miss first blood and stuff.
Yeah, I haven't been on that side too far, but I'm saying like there's going to be kills happening in mid instead. First blood is bot, second kill is top. Juchi skewers the Abaddon back into his tower.
Shouldn't
That's
be too much problem.
Careless.
It's got poor man shield and Curse of Avernus.
Mostly curious to see still how this mid lane is going to be developing. Someone is going to... Yeah, the Earth Spirit has already left the lane in the attempts on the Weaver top. So either the Ogre Magi stays and makes use of this opportunity to pressure the sniper more, or he is going to rotate for himself as well. And it's a kind of trade-off you need to think about. Like, you know there's probably a dual lane top right now. So, are you going to pressure their carry? Are you going to stay here? Are you going to try and perhaps swing this lane back into your advantage? There's so much patience coming out from DNZ. I think he has them convinced that he is not there anymore.
Yeah, they're rolling in again. They're looking for this. The Elspirit very patient there with the movement. And Mikey now going to throw out that impale and baits him in. And with those Radiant creeps on him as well, Silence is going to take a fall here. Severus will lose their support hero. And actually, Haze was very fortunate that he wasn't there longer. Nyx is trying to bait him in with and try and get him down low enough for the Elspirit to come kill. So DNZ once again waiting patiently for another peek out forward to kill.
The Ogre Magi mid is not actually working out. There is 16 to 8 on the sniper mid.
Yep, and now they're rolling in. TA 2000 in a lot of trouble. The shrapnel is at level 1 only though. Might not be able to kill him off, but nope. Penta will find him with the Orb of Venom, but he will tick down to the Ogre. So it's a 1 for 1.
That's a bit of a rough trade there, though. You really don't want the money for that kill to be going to your Ogre.
Wow, Jebs running aggressively into the Alchemist just to glimpse him back and slow down his farm.
That was great. That's a very heads-up play by him there. He just tanks right through the acid spray because he knows the Alchemist will want to be back as soon as possible. And he gets rewarded for that bit of game sense. So the Alchemist actually, yeah, he's moving into the jungle right now. Means some more levels for the Ogre, but that is not the start you want your Alchemist to get. And the Abaddon is just soloing the bot lane. Magnus is back up into the jungle. The lanes are not going the way of Cerberus. And I said after the last game that if they can manage to get out of the early game just right, they will probably do pretty well. But this is not looking like the start you want to have.
Well, like you mentioned, the early game is not all that matters, the levels, and right now the levels are pretty even. Abaddon is the first level 5 in this game.
Many Abaddon's levels don't matter too much except for maybe his mana pool.
Oh, they're going in again and they got so much firepower in this Weaver. The chain stunning is just insane here from Penta. Very well done.
That was some great team play.
Severus were expecting just Nyx Assassin to bully here, but the Elspirit and the Disruptor have turned up to this bully party, and now they can't afford to keep too many heroes here.
They are paying for this decision to keep the Ogre Magi mid even after the Elspirit has left. And the Elspirit is just following this Alchemist around, you can see him.
Yeah, coming in there, disturb him at TA2000 is in a lot of trouble. There is a possible glimpse. No glimpse. Feltus here. Throws out the ignite. But the roll away happens and DNZ should be okay. Nice stun there going out onto the Disruptor. They're gonna find it. Whoa! That kick! It's going to lock them all down. The sniper is there, but I think Jabs is going to fall here. Gets a double tick, and that's going to be a kill. Now Blazemorn in a lot of trouble.
Sniper
really shouldn't have gone in to help. He used the illusions to go shoot off that, but the shield comes out, and Penta will keep their sniper alive there. The Abaddon coming at the right moment, and Nyx Assassin here to clutch it for the fam. And Arrow going to fall there to the sniper of all people, the shrapnel raining down on him. And Penta really showing up in this fight.
Some great team awareness from Skyter there. A lot of safe lane carries do not carry a TP scroll, but if you're playing Abaddon, you gotta be aware of how powerful your Aphotic Shield is early. And Blazemon does not get out of that spot of bother without the support TP there. So in the end, that actually works out for them, even though it's literally threading the needle. And the only thing that Cerberus get out of it really is some space for Juchi on the bottom lane. But they're getting their mid lane pressured in right now.
No, the Curse of Vernus at level 4. Level 2 shield, I don't think I've seen this before. Usually it's max shield, but this is level 4 curse. This is very different.
It's great for making sure that people can't actually ignore you, because you will slow them forever. And you're in a ban, you can just keep running. they hit you back, you're gonna activate your ult. What are you gonna do?
Maybe I'll...
So, I'm liking this decision-making from him there. Mikey's got to watch out a little bit. He does not have support sitting behind him right now.
He's got Vendetta, he doesn't have to worry too much about anything jumping on him. This lane's in tatters, and but one thing is Juchi does have a lot of space for himself. The kick comes out, where's that silence? And alright, here we go, skewer him in, the glimpse is there. So a very optimistic TP for Juchi. He's probably gonna pop here, the shield will bust. Not even needed, Skitter just slashes him across the face, and that's a kill again. Going the way of Panther, 7-2 now, this game looking more like a... More and more like the Radiant favorite one.
It's looking like a ride for Penta once again, but in the previous game they gave too much space, even after having such a good start. And in this game they are up against an Alchemist. You can't give that much space to an Alchemist.
Yeah.
So in that sense I really like Cerberus's draft here. If Penta makes the same kind of mistakes, the way that Cerberus's heroes work is just going to punish them automatically. They don't actually have to make any extra plans to do that. So if Penta play their own game, they're still gonna get punished, is what I'm getting at. Which is a clever bit of drafting. I actually really like that.
Juchi once again caught out. Jabs is there. He's out of mana though. And the Magnus not skilling RP at level 6, meaning he will not be able to pick off that disruptor. But now they have the Empower. TA2000 going to go for that Ancient stack. He's got in, acid it up, but he's taking quite a fair bit of damage here from the Ancients. Has to be careful not to go down.
Benza going to be claiming their first tower here mid. And I think they will want to mid make a move on the bottom tower pretty fast after that.
Yeah, and felt in a lot of trouble here, getting clapped down by Blaze. That's the assassinate.
Not gonna kill him. They were very close to getting the glimpse off though. If he gets glimpse there, he is dead.
Yep. Wanted to use the assassinate for vision. Oh, Mikey in trouble. There is a stun. Oh, rolling in. They're just gonna wait for that. Time it very well. Mikey holding onto the stun. Good discipline. And we'll get that kill. The silencer dying again.
Great team play.
0-3 already.
So I was talking about no shenanigans with walking after it and activating Spike Carapace in hope of getting it triggered.
Yeah.
No. So if I am Cerberus right now, it might actually be better to feed a little bit more as long as you keep showing, because you want to keep pressure off of that Alchemist for as long as you can possibly manage. So you need to be defending this tower here. You need to keep showing the Weaver up here just to make sure that Penta has a reason to pay attention to all of these things and hopefully ignore the big guy farming in jungler. And they are stacking up for him now.
The main problem they with know. This lineup as I well is if Penta manages to get up to the, you know, close up Cerberus's map, Cypher is a really good hero to siege with, not afraid of any Magnus play, because he's just gonna stand really far back and shoot at your tower, not going to that choke point. So they have to be. I'll be really concerned. Yeah, even with Blink Dagger, there's Abaddon to build out the sniper, and Abaddon can run up to hit the tower, you know, pop that LT and then just run around. Sniper shoots faster. Everything just works out.
They can't afford to give up these two towers here.
They can't do anything about it. No Blink Dagger.
This is way too much damage.
Oh, this Ogre is in a lot of trouble. Gets run down here by Skitter. It's an easy pick here. Blazemon getting that kill. And now Silencer as well. Gonna be feeding the Silence. Dropping onto the Weaver just to make sure the minus two will not come in. As the Silencer already died there. Now nice RP gonna land. But is it gonna be enough? No. Immediate borrow time. They had to remove the RP stun. And Duchi in so much trouble. This game is spiraling out of control. Another shield TA2000 running away. Gets himself stunned. Gets himself kicked. There's the Silence. But Skitter running forward with the shield. He's doing so much damage. TA2000 toggling the armlet. And now Abaddon knows that something is up there. Gotta shield himself and walk away out of this one. Yep. Without that fire blast, they can't kill him. They TP, Blazemon takes the tier 2 tower, and they lose nothing. 12-3 now, Cerberus in dire states.
That was a very chaotic fight there. I thought for a second that Cerberus might be able to punish them for going so deep, but it was just a little bit too late. I think the Alchemist was thinking about pushing on top instead of taking the fight there. And after it ends up like this, that might have actually been the better play. At the very least, they didn't lose him there. And he, I believe he did get experience for some of these skills, so he'll be moving into that Radiance now. And if he manages to get there, they can stall out the game even more. But Penta do not seem to be ready to let this game slip like they did the previous one. The Abaddon is all the way past the...
Oh no.
Look at that disruptor, so far forward.
Missing the stun. Yeah, well, missing the stun there means no kill on the elk. But still, they force him
away.
But
it does mean a kill on the tower. Penta are not stopping.
Penta's not going to stop for this tower. The Weaver so poor because of the bullying that happened in his safe lane. Ring of Health and Belt of Strength, not even Threads or anything close. It's just a really poor Weaver. And Penta taking that tier 1 tower, smell more money to be made. They want more, but now they're going in there, throughout that impale there onto the Ogre. And they get the Assassinate as well, and that's an easy one for the Earth Spirit. 13-3. I thought they were gonna push that tier 2 up top, but they're gonna leave it to that Abaddon. The rest are coming middle to stop that push, not giving up any towers.
Yeah, the Abaddon is just completely safe here, and this is a nice bit of... You give some momentum to the mid lane, and then you move right back to bottom. It doesn't actually take them a lot of time at all, but it does secure them a kill, some pressure on mid, and a completely free tier 2 now too. And Cerberus have to start doing something. They need to make some kind of play happen if they want to. Maybe a smoke, maybe some kind of pickoff, maybe baiting Penta up to go too far.
Yeah.
Because if they don't, their last outer tower is going to fall. Or
yeah, this is the siege I was telling you about. Abaddon. Oh no, they bounce back Haze with that glimpse. The Weaver has to run all the way up top again. And this is the siege I was telling you about. Skitter goes up there, applies the curse, and Blazemon just takes advantage of that and shoots really fast with the curse of Avernus. Still trying to look for that sniper.
They are in such a tight spot here, and they can't just engage straight up into this lineup. They'll have to curve around somehow. But all the attention has been drawn up. And immediately the mid pushes on. I think a TA 2000 is in a bit of a dangerous spot here. This is the kind of area you want to
see him. There's a shrine. Oh, he's trying to build towards his relic. I don't know if they see him though.
No, they barely missed out on him. I was focused on the Nyx Assassin's vision, and his spider senses were tingly, but he just couldn't get the vision. Oh, and now he's got them.
And now he sees them. Arrow. Oh, missing the stun. Could immediately blink out of there in time. The Earth Spirit is going to get stunned there, though. There's the shield. Keeps him healthy for now. Global Silence gets deployed. I believe that's the first one of the game. TA 2000 running away. There's still a lot of damage that could be coming out here from this Abaddon going down, chopping onto TA 2000. Still holding on to that borrowed time. Meanwhile, what's happening here? The Ogre getting cornered again. And picked off. Felt will fall. For the millionth time this game, the Dire all shrine up. They're still waiting for a good point to use the RP. They have it, they have that blink, and they're gonna look to come in from the back. And this sniper is not going to expect it. Skitter does have that ultimate immediately, so he can shield his buddy, but he has to get out of that silence. Oh no, the Disruptor comes out with the Static Storm to counterplay the entire Cerberus squad and TA 2000 trying to stay alive, but Blazemon standing and delivering, turns on the machine gun to full automatic, strafes them all down, and Haze might be forced to use a shrine here. But yeah,
that was a
more disaster.
Mikey, did you see that?
Yeah,
incredible.
And Arrow,
yeah,
gonna tick as well, the Mist Coil will find him.
Oh. Well, that was the kind of play that they needed to try for, so once again props to them for just going out there and doing it. But I think it's too little too late, and this Abaddon has too many levels, his borrowed time is basically off cooldown every time it has been triggered. Yeah, all of their outer towers.
The thing
are gone
is
out.
That he's just like the perfect solution to Magnus because he can stay near his carry, and even if he does get hit by the Magnus, you just pop the borrowed time. You can do it while stunned, and then you save your sniper and get the hell out of dodge or turn it around.
It doesn't actually share damage from the team before you have your Aghanims though, and he does not have an Aghanims.
Yeah.
So it's more about the short distance on your spells. Abaddon does not have a lot of range.
Yep, Ice Frog is trying to make him the damage soaker with Aghanims instead of Centaur being a press and forget. You know, he's been nerfing Centaur's Aghanims upgrade nowadays. So now, as Abaddon, you have to at least know where you're standing and knowing when to use it. But they scouted Magnus. They don't have anyone
Abaddon
in the vicinity.
Basically on the same pace for his Sacred Relic as TAC.
Oh, there's the Impale again.
Right,
there is the Elspirit running in there, rolling very deep in with the stun and silence. Do they have enough to kill him? And with Magnetize, the answer is going to be yes, sirree. Jabs finds him in the Thunder Shock. And Felt still running around. Like, what do? It's Ogre.
He actually got spotted by the ward just there, but they just ignore him. Fenta have a plan. They're gonna do the classic move like this,
yeah.
And they had their vision in place once again. So this is going to be do or die for Cerberus.
Yeah.
They're defending the base for reals now.
Yeah,
no more training exercises. Aegis is up. Abaddon is gonna be hitting your towers.
Yeah, and RP is down, so
they
have global silence, but it's gonna be tough. The trick is to pop the Abaddon's ulti before he gets into the real fight. But that's proving to be extremely difficult. Blazemon, once again, doing that 1-2 punch there. Abaddon frontline sniper in the back there, causing trouble. RP is up.
It's working out great.
But this Frax is already gone.
Abaddon does not care, and there's a Radiance up on tier 2000, but I guess all you can do right now is try and keep the miss chance up on the Abaddon while he's hitting the building.
Hail Mary play, Magnus. Hail Mary play. There he is going to be it. The ultimate used there by Abaddon. They have the silence immediately as well, so the Alchemist is down. The global is there, but it's a little bit late there as Panta no longer fears the Magnus RP. He has it on deck, but is he gonna use it? The answer is no. The Impale from Mikey, always on point. They get a kill. Meanwhile here, Blazeman getting caught. There is going to be that Aegis. Magnetize is ready though. They're caught out here. They immediately pop the Shrine. Meanwhile, Sniper still giving, hand standing and delivering TA-2000. Yes, Red buys back into the game. Felt goes down. The Sniper's still alive. And yep, Skitter gonna run in there, trying to keep himself alive. He will tick though. Hayes in trouble, but the Thunder Strike and the Sniper are gonna be too much for him. Arrow runs back in just to feed another kill to the Sniper, who is now wicked sick. 25-7. Weaver buys back into the game, but he's under the detection of Sentry Wards. They're gonna scout him out. There's the Sakuchi blocked there with that spike. They're gonna find him. They kick the rock over. The kinetic field traps him in, and Hayes going down again as a dieback. Triple kill for the Sniper, and I think this game is over, Kips. I think it is.
I mean, in all of this chaos, they have managed to bring only one building down, and the Abaddon is dead for a little bit more. So perhaps Cerberus are able to sort of force them out of the base, but not like this.
Yeah.
No, it's not like
getting
this.
Caught again, Mikey. Doesn't even need to impale. They're still trying to focus on the place, Mom. And, yep, the glimpse. Alright, the melee rack stays alive for now. Is that gonna keep up though? Because there's gonna be a stun, there's gonna be a silence. He takes a huge hit from the assassinate. And Mikey gonna find the Alchemist again. Nice RP though, catches that, but he gets two shot there by Blazemon. And TA-2000, he has that Radiance. He walks down some people, but Blazemon is not gonna have any of that. Here comes the Lord of Avernus. Saves his life at the nick of time, and it's a Beyond God like sniper, 30-9. Okay, this game is
Abaddon,
just
what a hero.
Yeah, sniper,
and
what
I
a hero.
I'm really liking this Abaddon sniper combination. You ignore one, you get ripped to shreds by the other. And They're actually taking their time here. They've had enough of the bloodshed. They move away towards the shrine. That is some discipline right there. I am honestly surprised. If this was a game of mine, I would be running down mid already.
Yeah. Oh, just play it safe for now. Radiance is up for the Abaddon himself. Pace.
And the Abaddon, his net worth should be, I'm trying to bring it up here.
Net worth?
Yeah,
11,
his
000.
Net worth is ahead of the Alchemist.
Which is never a good thing.
He is going to get an AC, and he's going to get it way faster than the Alchemist can move into his Manta. Second Shrine is going to go down now, very methodical. They've also got the Vision up here still.
Mikey's got his eggs.
Ooh.
I love this. I think this is one of my favorite Aghanim upgrades.
I mean, I'm very partial to the Abaddon one myself as well, but yeah. The extra utility it brings to the hero is amazing.
Yeah.
It is so powerful. He's just farming the jungle for a little bit. If I'm them, I would just be moving. I don't think there's anything left to dissuade them from either going here or smoking up right now and making a curve movement like this. Because they can control everything. They can fight anyone. The only thing that might get in their way is a well-timed global silence.
We'll see if that happens.
You might be able to burst the silence or the sniper if you can make sure the Abaddon can't get his spells off.
Yep, pushing into that mid lane now, trying to go for that skewer in, and the glimpse is there, trying to punish any kind of placements. Mikey burrows into the ground, has that long and hill range. Gonna throw
the
that one out.
The siege machine is back on.
Mana burn, yeah. They have got a lot of siege machines. They got a mobile turret, mana burn thrower. There's a stun, landing onto Yoga. They're still trying to go for it, but no, the Alchemist gets caught in the static storm. He's down and out. 50 seconds on the sidelines, 2G as well. Gonna run away. Mikey's on a monster kill. Haze is dead. And the Ogre, good game, comes out and sends Severus. No, when they're beat, Panther just played too crisp Dota for them. And wow, the Skitter, Lord of Avernus, triple kill. 34-9, and I feel like this is not possible elsewhere. It's just that, you know, this game was pretty one-sided.